On this trip across Indiana, it's one of the safest hobbies around, uncovering years of dirt and rust from antique vaults. And once they're restored, even empty, they're worth big bucks. Plus, this traveling guitarist has the key to brightening anyone's day with song. Those stories and more as we strum our way across Indiana.
This trip across Indiana is made possible by the annual financial support from viewers like you and by the following corporate sponsor.
Brought to you by Conseco. How do you plan on funding your retirement? Conseco can help. Conseco, step up.
Up on this trip across Indiana, their fingers may get tired, but they are faithful to their craft. This Hoosier family has created six decades of sacred carvings for sanctuaries all across the state. Meet the Weberdings and more on this tour across your Hoosier homeland. Hey folks, Michael Atwood here with another excursion across the nation's 19th state. We've got good music, great stories, and a romantic getaway for your special Valentine on this trip across Indiana. But first, throughout the centuries, many famous artworks have disappeared due to decades of decay. But today, there are artists restoring those aged masterpieces, everything from the Sistine Chapel to, yes, even antique vaults. Producer Dan Nelson travels to New Palestine to meet an artist who's giving a unique art form a safe renewal.
I've got two or three that I've done and I'm working on now that's in the 1870s. But most of them are right in that era, the 1880s, 1890s, a few into the 1910s and 20s that I've done.
Stamps, rocks, baseball cards, coins. You name it and there's bound to be a collector out there collecting it. Custom painter Billy J. Espick collects and refurbishes these virtually indestructible antiques.
This safe over here, this is in the 1800s. I got this out of a third floor of a Masonic lodge. This is really, really neat. It's interesting. I've never seen two alike. I mean, every safe, I've done two or three from the same manufacturers, and they were striped completely different. So it was almost like maybe made to order. The characteristics of these things are like strange. I mean, they're really simple to elaborate to ornate to gaudy.
A nationally renowned automobile custom painter, Billy J. started refurbishing safes with the help of his clients.
Well, I had a customers basically saying, hey, I've got this old safe. I did pinstriping for this one gentleman, and he had an old safe, and he said, can you re-pinstripe it and everything? And I said, sure. So I did that, and it was kind of neat. And then a few years later, another customer of mine brought me a really neat old safe, an antique safe, and he said, I want to totally restore this back exactly the way it was. That turned out really, really cool. And then I did another one for another person, and then I got one for myself. And then it kind of snowballed where I seen another safe and I bought it and restored it. And as I did these and started digging into them and finding what was underneath the layers of paint, the pinstripe designs were just incredible what these guys did 100 years ago.
Billy J. may add a few special touches to these century-old pieces, but he restores these 2,000 to 3,000 pound antiques as close as possible to their original state.
To preserve a piece of history that these guys did 100 years ago and duplicate it, it's like today people go, oh, let's change this, let's change that. And it's like, you know, I figure these guys will haunt me if I don't do it right, you know. When I finish these things, it's real self-gratifying. I mean, it's like when I finish them, I mean, it's like I go, I mean, it's like, it's wow, you know, it's like that looks really neat. It's, you know, not so much that that I did it or could do it. And, you know, the customers, they love them. And you know, it's like if I feel like, if I like it, I know that they'll like it, you know. And it's one of those things that I have always put my heart and soul into. This safe, it's a Diebold, 1870. We're talking Civil War days, so right after the Civil War. So this was made from a cannon breech. All this is jeweled, and this thing is just, I mean, this is just awesome. This type of safe was placed in the center of a bank vault back in the cowboy days. So once I restore this will be quite a unique piece, so.
There aren't many 19th century safes around, which makes Billy J's hobby quite challenging. But his customers are willing to lend him a helping hand. Through his clientele, he found safes sitting in backyards, barns, and basements.
When I get one, the first thing I do is usually take the dials, the mechanical parts out of the safe, take them to a plater and get them replated, and then meanwhile, while I'm doing that, or they're doing that, I strip the safe down, see if I can find any remnants of any of the stripes.
After tracing the remaining markings, Billy J goes through a series of steps to make the safe as good as new.
They were a piece of art and was made and intended to last for 100 years, and the safes that I do are 100 years plus, and I mean the doors, the craftsmanship is just incredible on these things as far as the way they built them then. I don't know how those safes are manufactured today, but these old safes, they're like nuclear furnace proof.
As long as these antique safes are around, Billy J looks for the treasures buried deep beneath the grime collected throughout the centuries.
People refinish old furniture, you know, it's like, why not refinish one of these things? I've got the ability to do it. And hopefully these things will last, with my finish, another 100 years or more.
Just around the bend, get ready to sing along. This unsung hero strikes a loving chord with Hoosiers who need it most. Robin Harrison travels to Indiana's nursing homes and hospitals to bring back the sounds of the good old days.
But before we whistle a happy tune, let's meet up with a saintly Hoosier family. As a young boy, William Weberding found his talent, carving religious statues from wood. Now, six decades later, William no longer carves due to his health, but his sons are carrying on his holy craft. Producer Tiffany Eggers travels to Batesville, Indiana, to meet the sons who are holding on to a divine legacy.
The Weberding family, carving is in their blood. They are preserving a family tradition their father William shaped with a set of tools in 1942.
My dad was a master carver for Ron Weber Furniture in Batesville years ago. When he was 16, he got a set of chisels and he could carve, so he quit high school and he had knew some nuns through the churches around here, and one just asked him to start doing a statue for him. He carved it. And that nun told another nun, and then the priest learned about him, and it just progressed from word of mouth.
When each of the Weberding boys turned 7, their father presented them with their own set of tools. He then carefully trained them on the skills of his trade.
In Indianapolis, they used to have a hobby show. So he kind of put us on display, I think, Bill Jr. and myself. And we go up there and we had little bow ties on, and of course the people thought we were really, oh, look at these cute little dudes, you know. Right. And actually we was carving, and he was showing how the family, more or less, you know, we was trying to pick up his trade at that time, and it was
That's probably when we was about in maybe the sixth grade, seventh grade, something like that.
Since those early days, the Weberding Woodshop has chiseled thousands of religious statues and relics for churches all over the world. Each of their sacred pieces handled with expert care and attention from their faithful artisans.
No, it's a sense of accomplishment when you get done with something and see what you've accomplished. Guess I've got sawdust in my blood. Just all I need to know.
How long do you think you'll continue doing this?
Well, probably till I die.
This is an old statue. It's worth a lot of money. To restore it, you'll have less money in it, and you'll have something of value that goes back in history.
Right. Now, what will this look like when it's done? Will it look like the original?
It'll look like a brand new statue. And we'll do everything in earth tone colors, and it'll really be beautiful when it's done.
So what is the story behind these doors that you're recreating?
These doors are from St. Peter's Cathedral in Cincinnati. They're in the confession area is what they used to call it, and there's four sets of these three doors. What happened, they had a fire, and one set, complete set of these burned up. Reproduced the exact doors that they have there. Everything is exactly to what the doors are now. So when we put this into place, this will match all the other ones, color-wise, and you won't know the difference.
That's wonderful.
The Weberding carvers have more than just their talent and blood in common. These men are preserving an art form that's whittling away.
There's only probably a handful of us in the whole United States. There's a lot of whittlers, but to actually sit here on a bench and do this full time, 8-9 hours a day, that's kind of rare. It's good in that I feel almost in an exclusive club, but not because you want people to continue this, and after me or other ones are gone, who's going to do this stuff?
And as the Weberdings fashion their next sacred work of art, they know they hold a special gift. Not only a product that will outlive them in years, but an eternal bond between father and son.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing, I guess. I say he's pretty proud of us,
really. With hope.
Yeah, I don't know. He's been a great man.
And
we learned a lot. That's all I can say.
This portion of Across Indiana is brought to you by Hartsville.
Ah, Hartsville. What a lovely name, and an even lovelier town. As soon as we visited your Bartholomew County town, we knew it was love at first sight. So we wanted to compose a Valentine's love poem to express our devotion. Hartsville, we think you're grand. From your chapel to your school to your friendly postman. Hartsville, you sure are dear. From your fire department to your ancestors to even your beer. Hartsville, we admit you're sweet. From your homes to your history to the foods you eat. So Hartsville, remember, you're truly the king. And our words of advice, don't change anything.
Across Indiana, brought to you by Hartsville. Will you be mine, Valentine?
You know, it's not often we find someone who logs more miles going across Indiana than we do. But here's a guy who has us beat, hands down. Professional musician Robin Harrison is always on tour. He took his one-man show on the road years ago, and he intends to keep it there. All of which is very good news to the lucky people Robin plays for. Sweet music and sweet memories, that's what you get when Robin comes to town.
Back home again in Indiana, it seems that I can...
Columbus, Terre Haute, Brazil, Bloomington, a lot in Lafayette, Muncie, Anderson, Kokomo,
right here on this odometer. A quarter of a million miles of traveling around Indiana and playing music and having fun.
I don't know why I love it like I do.
I'm Robin Harrison, and I'm a musician. I play guitar and I play ukulele and I sing and perform at retirement homes, healthcare facilities, hospitals. The people I perform music for are retired people, often they're older people, and perhaps they've got some kind of physical ailment where they can't get around like they used to.
When I get up to go to work in the morning, I dig out my sheet music, and some of my favorites are right here in my hands. Mexicali Rose and Slow Pokes, Stars Fell on Alabama, Tiny Bubbles, Paper Dolly, Goofus, and I Don't Know Why, I Just Do.
I don't know why, I just do.
A lot of residents that don't normally respond to just verbalizations will respond to the music, and that's why it's real important that we do these programs.
Their music means an awful lot to them because the music they grew up with was directly involved with their family. Very personally involved, maybe sitting around the parlor on a Sunday afternoon, playing music, singing.
Or certainly church was a big part of their life and the music that the church had within. I finish up my program with several hymns that I play in sort of a clumsy manner on my accordion, just because I'm not a really great accordion player, but the accordion sounds like an old organ that you pump with your feet. I'm sure that the words to What a Friend in Jesus mean an awful lot to these people.
This is a picture of my dog, Kim. And I had her for 13 years, and she went everywhere with me. Sadly enough, she died 3 weeks ago. However, I now have another dog, a little puppy, and his name is Birch. Now Birch goes with me everywhere. Good morning, Lola. How are you, hon? Can I sing you a song today?
By the light of the silvery moon.
Robin is someone that our residents always enjoy. They look forward to having him come because he doesn't only entertain in a group, but he makes sure that he visits the people that are room bound, the ones that go have to stay in their rooms. He's always there for them too.
It had to be you, wonderful you. It had to be you.
Thanks, sweetheart. Appreciate that. Sometimes people think I'm like a good Samaritan or a philanthropist, but that's not exactly the case. I have my obligations, and I'm paid, and have made a good living for myself for several years doing this.
Well, all I can tell you is they look forward every month to having Robin come. He's one of their all-time favorites, and they may not remember his name, but it's that fella who plays the guitar.
These people are used to taking medicine, used to taking pills, but I'm sure there's no pill that can get the same kind of results as their favorite song that takes them back to a time when perhaps they had a little more sunshine in their life. And you can't argue with toes tapping and hands clapping, and it's a very magical thing.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much. Happy trails till we meet again.
Now, Robin does play an occasional gig for folks outside the healthcare facility family. Look for Robin Harrison and the Witch Hazel Valley Boys coming soon to a town near you. And finally, in honor of Valentine's Day, we decided to play Cupid. So we're remembering a former love story of a romantic getaway in South Central Indiana. And pay attention, men, because if you forgot a gift for your sweetheart again, this is the perfect way to kiss and make up. Producer Dave Stelk visits a hideaway in Columbus, Indiana, during this Across Indiana 10th Anniversary Classic.
Bill and Kathleen Bowen have a passion about preserving passion in other people's lives. And that passion has fueled the Bowens to build this place, a simple getaway. Welcome to the Country Chalet, a retreat for couples, what Bill and Kathleen refer to as a lover's paradise, an architectural delight. The Bowens built the Country Chalet with their own four hands. They had practiced building a similar place in Northern California.
Well, we decided to build the place in California named Camelot because when we looked around for a place to go for our own honeymoon with this kind of an idea in our minds, we couldn't find it anywhere. And we just said to each other, if we don't build it, who's going to? It doesn't seem to exist.
Bill and Kathleen sold the California retreat and eventually decided to build their latest hideaway near scenic Brown County, Indiana. The idea was to build a simple love nest, no vibrating beds here. Subtlety and detail are the themes. They even fine-tuned the waterfall.
Well, you'd think you put a waterfall in and the water comes down and that's it. Not so, because it splooshes and splashes and it makes what would be a real annoying sound at first. And you have to play with putting rocks here and slowing it down there and speeding it up here. And it's really quite a problem. Well, detail, it can be something that you see or it can be something that you don't see. And having all that blend, and it's what gives harmony.
The Bowens thought of everything.
There's a curling iron and a hair dryer in the bathroom in case the lady forgets that, or in case the guy's surprising her and bringing her and doesn't know to pack it. We've got the popcorn and the brownie mix stuffed right in with the videos in case you're going to watch a movie. There it is. There's corn in the cob holders right here in the drawer. Well, we like to call it hands-on from a distance. We want people to feel like they're pampered. We want them to feel like they're really treated special, but at the same time, we want them to feel like they have the privacy and they're on their own, and this is their time, their place, their surroundings.
Did you get the back door locked?
Back door's locked, this door's locked. The music's on, waterfall's going.
Great.
In fact, Bill and Kathleen make it a point not to be around when the guests arrive. But the Across Indiana crew wanted to stick around to meet the lucky lovebirds. Tom and Lynn Bigley came to the chalet to celebrate their 35th wedding anniversary. Immediately, the Bigleys were enchanted with the waterfall.
Where do you want me to put your suitcase?
Gosh, I don't know.
No, I can take it for you.
No, I don't really know where the bedroom is.
Well, it's through here. Would you like to see the bedroom?
Sure.
All right.
Yeah, let's.
It's not easy to make a marriage. It takes time, and having the chance to have just time together is very important.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
We left the Bigleys alone for the evening. Meanwhile, the Across Indiana crew went back into town and spent the night in deluxe accommodations, recognized, by the way, as North America's finest economy lodging. We didn't have a grotto bathroom, but ours was sanitized for our protection. And sure, we didn't have a waterfall running through the room, but we did have a leaky faucet in the bathtub and all the ice we could carry back to the room.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How did things go?
Oh, wonderful.
Listen, I brought you some Egg McMuffins.
Oh, come on in.
It's an enchanted place, really, for anyone, but for someone who's thinking about the love they've enjoyed for 35 years, this is a good place to come and reflect on that.
The Bigleys gave the Country Chalet a great review, and that's exactly what they wrote in the guestbook, also noting that the Across Indiana crew was fun and not an imposition.
The waterfall didn't drive you nuts, did it?
Let's see, I think I got up and went to the bathroom 3 times during the night, and I think you got up twice.
That was just a friendly reminder to all our husbands out there that it's never too late to buy flowers. And for my Valentine, I remembered, you'll be getting chocolates. I'm Michael Atwood, thanking you for tuning in to another edition of Across Indiana. And until next time, have a safe journey across our beloved Indiana.
This trip across Indiana was made possible by the annual financial support from viewers like you and by the following corporate sponsor.
Brought to you by Conseco. How do you plan on paying unexpected medical bills? Conseco can help. Conseco, step up.
On our next trip across Indiana, in honor of Black History Month, we meet Indiana's first African-American female news reporter. Indy's own Barbara Boyd says she may have got the job because she's a minority, but that's not the reason she kept the job. Her story of triumph and success on our next journey across Indiana.
Hit the spot.
It's worth it.
And I have been told that all the cow-